guys, welcome back. Spiritual Healing and Spell Works 101 with me, Stephen. Guys, I'm still continuing on the teachings and education on the Orisha. This is delving into the belief system, the religion, if you'd like, but better said, the tradition of Santeria. It's an extremely beautiful relationship to have, a tradition to be in and part of. It's extremely beneficial. It's just powerful and amazing. So just to teach you a little bit more about that today, we'll be speaking about the goddess of the oceans, Yemaya. Again, this is from ancient African origin. It's extremely ancient. All of the Orishas are ancient. They're extremely powerful, varying degrees. This one in particular is extremely powerful in her aspects. So, like I said in the previous video, you get three different types of Orishas that we can delve into whenever you'd like to get in contact with me if you'd want to. This one in particular is a goddess, not just an ancient or an ancestor, she's an actual goddess. So she's extremely powerful. Another thing to always remember with all of them, they are all open to relationships. They are just steps and practice that have to be maintained and seen through properly and correctly. Guys, it is super, super important to not do the things incorrectly. It won't just not work, it can also backfire. So it's not that simple, but once you get the hang of it, having a relationship can be so easy and so beneficial to you. So in particular with Yemaya, she's extremely helpful and powerful in beauty, bringing beauty into your life and into your being. She's a nurturing figure. She's the embodiment of life and power and abundance. That's what the water is, life, and she brings that in. She helps with fertility because of her mother nature. She helps with fertility. She helps with trauma. She helps in relationships. If you have bad relationships or trauma, she can assist in that. And these are just some of the things she brings into a relationship with you. Now again, guys, you got to be aware, and like I've said before, if you want to take it a few steps higher, if you want to do a spell, if you want them to do a hexing on your behalf, and not all of them do hexing, some do, and some do it better and more fiercely. Okay, like I said before, Shango, he's extremely primal and fierce. She's not primal, but she is fierce and she's protective. So keep in mind, your altars is signs of respect and offering unto them, and that'll bring them into your presence. And once you do this, guys, keep in mind, it's not something you just chuck away. That can also lead to trouble. So take these things very seriously. And if you want them to work on your behalf, and you don't feel comfortable doing it, because to take things to another more powerful level, you got to bring in things like blood sacrifice, and it doesn't sit well with everyone because it's cringy, it's animals, it's not as taboo though as you think. There's actually very beautiful understanding behind it once you understand it. And so when you need more powerful things done, that's when you contact someone like me. We do it on your behalf. And so if you, for a personal relationship though, for your own little altar and setup, just to get that base down and that beauty in your life, help with fertility, that's the case, help with trauma and healing. You'll need to start an altar to her, consistent of her favorite things and things that resonate with her. Her colors are blue and white. So you have blue and white candles, as many as you like. The bigger and more elaborate, I'll be honest, the better. They love the attention, they love offerings. They absolutely love it, the Orisha. Use materials, blue and white materials, cloth. She loves watermelon. She loves coconut cakes, coconut flakes, anything coconut. Have it there. The more the better. And flowers. Again, as much flowers as you like. She loves fresh flowers because she is all about life. And short of water, flowers represent life like anything, you know. And you call it in. You show her the sacrifice, the offering. And what's powerful is knowing her day, which is Saturday. You can do it any day, but I would start it on a Saturday. And her number is number 7. You can keep that in mind when you do your altar, either 7 levels, or it's 7 a.m. or 7 p.m. or somewhere incorporate 7. Guys, I hope that is educational. If you have any further questions, comment down below, email me. If it's assistance you need, counseling, help, magic done on your behalf, or interceding done on your behalf, get hold of me. We'll set up a session and like I said in the comments down below, you'll see it's in the description. I offer counseling, I offer spell books on your behalf. I'm there for you guys. Be blessed, and till next time, cheers.